Okay, kids, so today we are going to learn something new. All of you can hear me? Raise your hand.
I cannot see.
Okay, where is Ishan? Okay, I'm creating a new project as usual. And I will rename this project. Variable. Today we are going to learn this term, which is variable, and saving this project. Okay, let's jump to the question. This is the question.
Where do you get this from?
What?
Where do you get this from?
This is a question list which I have. I will share with you.
Okay.
Okay, so first thing is, what is our requirement for this project? Component needed means sprites needed. These are two sprites, left button and right button, which we needed. Okay, got it? Two sprites we want. Okay, let's create these two sprites. Now we don't have this kind of button in our sprites list. So what we will gonna do? We are going to draw it. Okay. I have clicked on draw button. Now I will draw left button and then right button. Okay. I am selecting this square option, rectangle tool, and I am creating a rectangle for button. See how it's looking? See, like this. I am creating these two buttons, okay? One by one. You can ask me whenever you have any doubt, okay? Raise your hand whenever you have any doubt. I'm changing this color with red.
Red.
Okay. And I'm writing L.
How can you write?
With this stroke tool.
Oh.
Okay. And I will color this with black color. I'm choosing black color and paint. That's it. Our left button is ready. Okay. Any doubt? What we will do now? We will copy this here, duplicate. Can you see this? Here. You can see this now? I'm copying this, okay? Now I have duplicate of this button. What I will do? I will just rub this L and I will write I am changing color with red. Okay, and I'm painting black color. Got it? Any doubt here?
No.
So now we have two sprites ready. We will use this. I'm changing this with this and I'm copying this block. Oh. We will make it large, okay?
Okay.
So to make it large, which option we have to use? Can you say? Do you know which block we use to make to change sprite size?
Size.
We will go to action. We will set size or change size. We can use any block. Okay. We can use this also. Change size by 50. We have to add more. This is okay.
A little.
And we go into action and we can also use this set button. Set size to say 150. What is the problem here? We have to change this purple bunny, okay? Let me first set the location. I'm clicking on this pin and setting the button at proper location. Clear? Left button and right button. We have these two sprites and we can change its size by using change block or set block. Clear?
Yes.
Any doubt? Aro, any doubt?
No.
Okay. Now let's move ahead. We will go to question. Now what we have to do? Functionality. We have to create two variables, left and right. Now what is variable here in category list, in blocks list, you can see this variable. Can you see this?
Yes.
Yeah.
Variable category.
Yes.
Now what is variable? Listen carefully. Variable is a container which stores value like 1, 2, 3, any digit. It can store minus digit also and plus digits also. It is simply a container which can store value. And that value, we can set that value, we can upgrade that value, we can decrease the value, we can change its value. Okay, got it?
Yes.
And we can give the name to that variable like score. Okay? Let's understand this term using example. Okay? We will create a variable. I'm going to this variable category and here I'm choosing this set block. Set I to say 0. For applying the digit, we will go to math category and I'm using this 0 block. I'm joining this 0 here. Now I can read this like set I to 0 means I is variable kind of container which can store value 0 in it. But I want to change this I with name score, which is meaningful. Score. Score is a name. Okay. Right now, what is the value of score? Anyone can say me? Who will answer first? Yes, Jibji, Jabji. Answer me. Answer. I can't hear you. Unmute yourself.
I'm gonna rejoin. My Wi-Fi is not working.
We have to set score to 0 and then change it after.
Yes. Right now its value is 0. Clear? Let's move ahead. Now what is the functionality? When left key is pressed, increase left variable by 1. As I have said you that its value can be changed. It can be increased or decreased. So here what we have to do, we have to increase the variable when which event is occurring here when left key is pressed. Got it? We'll go to event when left key is pressed. Will this code work?
No, because you have to put something in the left.
This block will not work. Why? Because we have to use this left button, which is a sprite. Clear? we have to use this block. When sprite click, I'm selecting here. Right sprite. Okay, when left key is pressed, we have to increase the variable, okay? There is mistake in question. To increase or decrease the variable value, we have to use this change block. Change value of variable by any digit you can use. If you're using 1, it will increase by 1, like from 0 to 1, then next cycle 1 to 2, in next cycle 2 to 3. Got it? If I use here 2, it will increase by 2 digit, from 0 to 2, then 2 to 4, 4 to 6. Clear? 6 to 8. But here I am using 1. So each time its value will increase by 1. First time it is 0. Next time it will be 1. And third time it will be 2. And then 3 and 4 and so on. Clear? Okay. Here we have to change this variable with score. Change score by 1 whenever right button is click. Let's run it. Here I am pressing this right button, but I am not able to see the score. How I will be able to see the value of score? We have to use title block. Okay, for that we have to go to text category. I am using this show title screen. I am using here join block, text join. I will go to variable and use this score block. Here I will write score, and this score variable will print its value. Let's run this. I'm clicking on run button, clicking on write. Okay. This is a left button which I have selected. So whenever I will press on left, see, score is increasing by 1, 3 to 4, 4 to 5. Whenever I'm clicking on left button, it is increasing by 1. Got it? Okay, now we will increase it by 2. I'm changing your value from 1 to 2. Change score by 2. Now what will be the answer? I'm running this code. I'm clicking on L. score is 2 first time from 0 to 2. Now what will be the answer when I will click on left button? Anyone can say me?
It will turn to 4 and then 6.
4 and then 6, right? 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. Got it?
What if you press the right button?
What?
What if you press the right button?
That code we are going to create, okay?
Oh.
I'm copying this block. Everyone know how to copy block?
No.
Yes.
No. We have to select the block which we want to copy. Then we have to click Control C in our keyboard and then Control V.
Wait, what? C then?
Control C and then Control V. Clear?
Yes.
Now I'm copying this block.
Is that right or wrong?
No, what's that smell? What's that smell?
What I will do here? I will write minus 1. What it will do?
0.
If my value is 5 and I'm using minus 1, what will be the answer? 4. 5 minus 1, 4. 4 minus 1, 3. It decreases its value. Okay? Now, I'm copying this join block. I'm changing this variable to left because we have two variables.
What did you okay?
What happened?
Where did you get that from?
Okay, from this variable set block.
Oh.
By default it is I. We can change from I to any name.
What does
any meaningful name?
What does I mean?
I is a variable. I say now variable is a container which can store any digit, any value.
Okay.
I is the name of that variable. I is the name of container. And I have changed that I with name left and right. I have created two variables. See, here I'm changing its name with right.
Okay.
There are two variables, left and right, and its value is 0. First time it is 0. Then we will increase and decrease accordingly. Okay? I'm writing here left and here right. In subtitle, I'm using right. Subtitle will show at bottom and title will show at upper side. Okay.
Hey, after class, maybe I'll do this coding.
Yes, you all have to do this. Okay.
On my computer?
Yes. When I will run this code, you will get it. How it's working. I'm changing the variable right. See, whenever it is clicking on left button, it is increasing the value. And whenever it is clicking on right button, it is decreasing the value. Okay? Let's learn it. No. I'm clicking left button.
What?
See, what is value of left? Zero. I forgot to change the variable name here. Change left and right. Okay, reset. Now can you see this? Left is increasing whenever I'm clicking on left. And now right. Right is decreasing. Minus 1, minus 2, minus 4. Clear?
Yes.
Let's set the value of right 10 for better understanding. I'm changing this value to 10. Now what will happen from 10 to 9, 9 to 8 when we will run and we will click on right? It's becoming from 10 to 9, 9 to 8, 8 to 7, 6, 5, 4. Whenever I'm clicking it, decreasing its value. Because I have right here, change right by minus 1. Clear? Okay, Arav is clear and others? You can play with numbers. You can try here different numbers. I'm changing this with 5, suppose. Okay, whenever I click on left button, it will increase by 5. Let's run this. 5. First time from 0 to 5, because 0 plus 5, what is 5? 5 plus 5? Who will tell?
10.
10.
Yes, so I'm clicking left, 10. Then 15. You can get your table, 5 table. 5 ones are 5, and then 10, then 15. Got it? Any doubt in this project? Everyone clear with variable? Who will say me what is variable?
Variable is a container that holds values and you can change it and use it.
Yes, you can change that
a variable. Something that changes forever.
Yes, we have to set it for once. First time we have to set its value. Okay, it is necessary. First time we have to store some value in that container, then we can change that value. And we have to give name to that container. We have to give meaningful name. Here I am giving meaningful name, left. This is left button, so I have given that container a name left. And here I have given the name right. It is meaningful, so we can understand easily. Clear? Any doubt? We have time. Any doubt?
No.
I do.